she was in our team for nearly 2 years. There's about 20 of us. She was a really popular member of the team. She made some really good friends. And when she died, we had a really strong feeling. We wanted to do something worthwhile, something that would be close to our heart, something that would be a proper lasting legacy for her. I'd spoken to Andrew Gray at the museum because she used to volunteer there. She was always trying to educate us. She was bringing in things all the time, big pheromones and all sorts of things, and telling us things about them. And when Andrew mentioned the Inspire Youth Zone that he works with, it just seemed like the perfect thing. So we could get kids interested in wildlife, in the local wildlife particularly, and how to protect wildlife. And that lasted for a lifetime. That would just be the perfect thing. That would have been so close to Nancy's heart.
So far, we've done pond dipping, and we had to identify them using the magnifying glass, and I really like how it went just was staying in a classroom and the teacher just telling us we actually got to do something, so it was a little bit more intriguing instead of you just sitting down and listening. I learned that there are more than one type of frog, and that one of them have like a superhero mask sort of eyes.
So our affiliation with Inspire has kind of grown over the years. It started off many years ago with Bolton Lads and Girls Club, where we had an affiliation with them, and actually took one of their kids out to Costa Rica, which was a life-changing experience for them. We raised the funds, and it was something that really sort of, it was amazing to be able to do that. This kid had not even got a passport. I'm local to Chorley, and Inspire itself is fantastic. It gets the kids off the streets. It really means that they can engage with things that they wouldn't normally be able to do. And that sort of opportunity to do things that they wouldn't normally do and see things that they wouldn't normally see, mix with people that they wouldn't normally be able to do, really makes a kid, you know, grow into a proper adult, you know, someone that's enthusiastic about things. And, you know, I wish there'd have been something like this when I was a kid, because, you know, it is fantastic that some of the things they're able to do here really broadens their outlook on life.
And I'm 11. I think it's great because they get to learn a lot. They get to have fun at the same time, and also get some exercise.
I just love like using binoculars in this like house thing to see, like, there's this massive thing with lots of holes in it, with little birds flying in and out. And I got to see with my binoculars, see what they were doing. I've learned that some birds, some very rare birds come here, and some butterflies and birds they've only seen once. Because you get to see all the wonderful things like birds, especially that hare that was sat outside the building that everyone saw and having a little sleep.
So in the summer we actually brought a lot of our animals from Manchester Museum to Inspire, to Chorley. We brought frogs, snakes, lizards, chameleons. And it was absolutely brilliant. It was the first time we kind of brought animals in from the museum. It's kind of what we do at the Manchester Museum. We kind of use the collection to really get kids interested in nature. And, you know, a lot of the kids in Inspire, when we brought them in the summer for this holiday club, they'd never seen chameleons, they'd never touched a snake. And some of our rare frogs, you know, they're amazing. You know, you show a kid one of these frogs and they open their eyes in front of them, and they're blown away with it, and that really captivates them. And that's what it did with the holiday club. It really got them interested in nature.
Normally, if you just go to a zoo or safari, you don't really see the animal. You just look at them. But there, you actually got to hold them, and it was a better experience than just sitting in your car and going through.
Well, I've learned that sometimes you can't touch things that you find in a pond, because we found a toad, and it was poisonous, and we weren't allowed to touch it, but it was really cool.
We saw lots of birds, we saw lots of insects, we saw amphibians, we saw little toads and things like that. So So, you know, the opportunity on our doorstep just to be able to go and take the kids there was something really kind of unique.